Alright, we're gonna kick it right back into Loser's Quarters. We've got Nadia on Pikachu. We've got It's Sonic on Toon Link. It's time for some brand new Smash action. Overlays fixed. Oh wow. DC with the call out on its, or Nadia with the call out on its Sonic second jump. Take an early first stock.
Still stuck in the last match.
Thunder, obviously, exceedingly powerful, much like it was in Brawl, if anybody remembers. An unnecessary buff, but one that Pikachu is extremely grateful for as he explains. I think it's Dylan's food. He's playing Squad Strike. Or no, he's finished Strike. Never mind. We're gonna see It Sonic do his best to create some space, chip away at Nadia's lead. He's doing a pretty good job of it so far. We're almost at the percent threshold for Boomerang or Bomb into up air to kill. Interesting, he only got the stall part of the stall then fall with that down air. Right now we're seeing Nadia do an excellent job staying patient, not overextending, doing his best to smartly build up his lead. Much like the way he played towards the latter end instead of his king. Well, I think it's Sonic tried to bait out an option from Nadia there, probably some kind of smash attack. We tried to bait a roll there, Nadia was all the wiser. Nadia can steal this first stock. I can steal the second stock like he does right there. I can see I have the utmost faith in him that he will close this game out. Pretty straightforward with me. It's gotta be pretty difficult for Toon Link to do much against Pikachu, considering how small his frame is and how mobile he is here. But that was an excellent punish there on the missed up B angle. You see a forward air when first comes. Here comes down with the downer. That's a lot of damage right there. Nadia's a full stock ahead. Once again, extending his lead very nicely. I think it's Sonic is going to have a lot of trouble playing from behind in this matchup. And there it is! Nadia takes game one with a well-timed air swipe. Sending him down to the heavens. Friday the Mudkip flashing when it comes up from the crowd. Shout out to Jordan. Alright, we're going to game two on Yoshi's Story. I'm guessing that it's Sonic just wants to limit the amount of space that Pikachu has to run around him. He's off to a much better start than the first game, than how the first game began. That had to be a miss input, but he's not going to get punished for it. Say, I feel like Toon Link just kind of lacks the powerful up-close options to deal with Pikachu out of shield, and when he's choosing his initial movement options. I feel like Pikachu is really going to struggle to create his own offense, create his own space in this matchup. Throughout the set, Nadia has been controlling the pace of gameplay, but that's a good conversion. We got Boomerang into fair. Forward air right there. There we go, he covers the get up with a grab. Now he's got Nadia exactly where he wants him. Only a 25% deficit between these two. There's a bomb A glide toss bomb into up air. And it's Sonic takes the first stock. Fair situation. Oh, he gets right in the neutral get up. Missed time his dash attack on that too. Here, all Sonic.
Hey, it's Big Sham here for a little mid-game insight. I think Aiden really has to download this matchup, even with a bit of a lack of experience. If he can really pull this out and fish for the aerials that he needs, I really think he has a chance of winning this set. This has been Big Sham. Thank you and good night.
Interesting analysis coming in there from Big Sham. Hope you all enjoyed hearing Big Sham talk for that brief amount of time. He's definitely one of the most colorful personalities we have here in the tribe. It's always a pleasure to see him come out to events and continue to improve with the rest of us. Anyways, seeing even stocks at 50% weak against Sonic, it looks like this counterpick of Yoshi's story is paying dividends for him. Seeing the audio being forced to approach for the first time in the set, the pace of gameplay is getting shifted towards the way it's Sonic and Sonic wants to play. Up airs. Obviously, his damage output does not match the length of time that his combos and his combos require to be executed, so he didn't put in too much of a dent to hit Sonic's lead. Oh, excellent conversion. Great awareness of where the boomerang is going to send Nadia. Picks up the back throw. The classic beat, as a lot of us would say. And Sonic has a commanding lead in this game for two. Oh, the up air trade hit Pikachu's down air. Yeah, we see it, Sonic taking his time, making excellent use of the platform, forcing Nadia to approach, remaining in space with his uncomfortable beam. Pikachu has to be extremely close to the opponent, but far away, zoning the Thunder Blitz. And on your story, it just doesn't really seem like Pikachu gets to play in the space that he wants to play. Excellent counterpick coming from the Sonic. That floor it might have killed him to connect it. Instead, he's just gonna maintain stage control, reads the out, reads the rollout, then up air and hit Sonic. Cheap stocks Nadia, and he's able to play with the Sonic. Win! Yeah, you could definitely be onto something there, Flame. Seemed like you made the correct adjustments.
Stop battle! Pikachu! Cold Wind!
Alright, so Yoshi's Island is going to be the counterpick for Nadia in this game number three. Property of Thunderbolts in that platform to prevent get Sonic from sharpening the up airs. Let's see how this see how the early portion of this match plays out. See Nadia off to a bit of a lead, quickly being evaporated by Sonic up to the up air. It's always been a reliable, confirmed, and continually cat across all iterations of Smash. Dabs on shield. Dash attack is punished with the jump and fastball back air. Very even percents early on in this game, number three. Oh, F smash on landing. Doesn't get the sweet spot though, so it's not going to kill him. It's a little bit preemptive there with the down air, and it's Sonic does recover back to game safely. Thank you. side reaction to set up for option. Gets the up smash, Nadia responds quickly with an up smash. We are at even stocks in game 3. He hasn't said a word in the last half hour. Yeah. Excellent string coming in from Nadia. And all of a sudden, he darts ahead in this game number 3. Somebody please clip that. Please clip it. Sonic with a bomb into up smash. He's gonna do his best, to recover and come back in the stage, but I think we're going to see the same issue that we saw in game 1, where now Nadia has the green light to play at his exact pace. He's going to be making use of, he's going to be staying at that 45 degree angle of green light, making use of thunderbolts, making use of borders, solid green hitboxes, and ensuring that Insonic cannot pull off any of his intelligent two-way concerns. Goes for another down air. White pan out for him. Back air. Short up back air. Such an excellent option in the field. I believe back air is frame 4. It's a frame 7 in the field. It's able to punish a lot of landing errors. Even Palutena is forward. It was able to punish it. Making great use of it to punish the play. For the boomerang, but it's Sonic cannot capitalize further. Bomb into fair. There we go. It's Sonic brings it back to the last stock situation. He's at 97%. He's going to have to win neutral a couple of times to bring it back to even percentage. Let alone clutch this game out and move ahead in game 3. Oh, he tries to call up and he can get up with the thunder. But if Sonic was all the wiser to it, he waited. There's an 84% deficit between these two players. If Sonic is doing his best to force Nadia into a situation where he can be punished for throwing out potentially a powerful but laggy move and then capitalizing on it, he's doing a pretty good job of chipping away at Nadia's lead, but Nadia is not biting on a lot of the baits that Sonic is throwing out. Somehow falls out of the thunder connection. Raises his percent, but he's still safe for now. Rolls behind the F smash. We have to hope that Nadia's morale isn't damaged by missing a couple of seemingly surefire KO offs. Oh my goodness! Rough DI on that back throw, but he's gonna be fine. There we go, Nadia gets the dash attack. It's a 2-1 lead in this loser's quarter set. A battle between Saskatchewan and Manitoba. Let's go, Aiden. Whose water is that? It's yours now.
Cold Wind Pikachu!
Game 5. Let's go, Aiden. It does take a long time. You got a bunch of filthy campers. This game sucks. Broken ass move. But Aiden's DI is nice. Aiden's DI is nice. That move's fucking stupid, but Aiden's DI is amazing. Man, no one can kill each other here. Holy shit, it's been. Oh, yeah. Holy shit! Let's go, Aiden! Yeah! Let's go! Aiden's so smart and so sick. Alright, 3 minutes in, we got one stock off. Let's fucking go!
Yeah.
big-ass sword. Let's go, Nadia. Let's go, Aiden! So we got one filthy spammer versus another less filthy spammer. Okay, good read. It's clearly biased commentary. Yeah. Let's fucking go ice skate. This is clear. Yes, Chaz. This is a good recovery. He hugged the wall, so he's like, I'm gonna attack regardless. Oh! Okay, it's true. This is scary. He's falling apart. There we go. That's incredible. Sick. Huge brain, galaxy brain, SK. Alright, we got one back here. Fuck, he's gonna get timed out. Fuck, I fucking hate this game. Filthy. Campers. He just unga bunga throwing items in hitboxes. Oh, let's go, let's go.